This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to calculate annual percentage yield, or APY. Our problem says, find the annual percentage yield for a stated or nominal interest rate of 4.5%, compounded quarterly, and compounded continuously. Here's what this means. You know that if you put money into a bank and the bank told you they would pay 4.5% interest and the interest would be compounded quarterly or maybe compounded continuously, at the end of a year you would have ended up earning a little bit more than that 4.5%. The amount that you actually earned at the end of a year is the APY. And what we want to do is figure out what the APY would be for 4.5%. Let's start with the compounded quarterly. Okay, now to make this an easy problem, since it doesn't say how much money you're investing, let's assume that the amount you're putting into the bank, the principal, is just $1. And let's assume you're putting it into the bank for 1 year. So now let's work with the formula we have for interest, which is compounded. The formula says that A, this is the amount you're going to get back, equals P times 1 plus R over N raised to the nt power. But remember, principal is $1. So multiplying this by 1 doesn't make any sense. We can just get rid of that P altogether. And T is 1, so multiplying N times 1 is not going to help. So we'll just get rid of the T. Now we've got A equals 1 plus R over N raised to the N. Okay, so remember, R is the interest rate, the annual interest rate. If we state that as a decimal, it's 0.045. And N is the number of compounding periods per year. It's compounded quarterly, so N is 4. So we just want to divide 0.045 by 4. And we get 0.01125. That means that 1 plus R over N is the same as 1 plus 0.01125. So we can just say A equals 1.01125. I just added those numbers together. And we want to raise that to the N power. Well, N is 4 because it's quarterly. Okay, so now we've got a fairly simple problem. It's just A equals 1.01125 raised to the 4th power. We can put this into the calculator, and what you'll find is if you put that in the calculator, you get something like 1.045765, and the number would keep going. So let's just round this to A equals approximately 1.0458. Now remember, A is the amount of money you get back from the bank. A includes both the amount of money you invested and the interest. Well, in our problem, you invested $1. So if we want to find the interest, we have to subtract $1 from the A. That means the interest is going to equal approximately 0.0458. That's just 1.0458 minus 1. And then what we want to do is turn that into a percentage. So we just multiply that by 100 and make it a percentage. It's going to be 0.458%. Okay, so the answer to the compounded quarterly part is 4.58%. Which kind of makes sense. It's a little more than the 4.5% that we started with. Okay, let me review the steps for this, and then we'll go back to the compounded continuously part of it. All we did was take the formula for compounded interest, the A equals P plus P times 1 plus R over N raised to the NT, and got rid of the P and got rid of the T because we called both of those numbers 1. Then we had a much simpler formula. We plugged in the numbers that we had, the percentage rate, and that was the R, and the number of compounding periods, that's the N, we calculated what A equaled. We remembered that A also includes the amount of money we invested, which was 1, so we subtracted 1 from it, and we ended up with the interest rate. We turned the interest rate into a percentage, and that's our answer. Okay, let's do the compounded continuously part of this. So the formula for compounded continuously is A equals P times E to the RT. Once again, let's assume that P is $1 and the time is 1 year. So we don't need the P or the T. So now we've just got A equals E to the R, and R is 4.5%. We want that as a decimal. So that's A equals E to the 0.045. We use a calculator to figure out what that is. And what we get is that A equals approximately 1.046027. And once again, this number keeps going. So we'll take this and round it. We'll make it A equals approximately 1.046. And then we just want to subtract the original dollar that we invested from this 1.046. So we'll get the interest, which is 0.046. We turn that into a percentage by multiplying it by 100 and adding a percentage sign. So it's just 0.46%. And that's the APY for the compounded continuously part of the problem. Okay, so you might want to run through this yourself a couple of times just to practice it. It's a fairly logical procedure, and I think you'll be fine with it. Take care. I'll see you next time.